Hello, I'm Gary Bartz. I teach saxophone at Oberlin Conservatory of Music. I've been there for about 12 years. I would like to talk about the difference between composing and improvising, because I'm insulted when I'm called an improviser. I looked up the word improvise. It meant not prepared, unrehearsed, and off the top of your head, you know, spur of the moment. Nothing that I play is spur of the moment, believe me. You know, I've been doing this 40, 50 years. Nothing is spur of the moment. I know everything that I'm gonna play is in my head right before I play it. Sometimes it's at the same time as I play it, but I still meant to play that. Now, the only time that I improvise is when I make a mistake. Now I have to improvise. That's on the spur of the moment. I didn't plan to play that, so I have to improvise. And that's fun. maybe that's why people want to call it improvising. I know Miles, I used to hear him say to people, you know, I love your mistakes. Because when you make a mistake, you have to scramble and try to make it seem like it was not a mistake. You know, like when you stumble, you walk down the street, you stumble, and you act real cool, that's what I meant to do. The same thing, that's improvisation. Now, composition is a whole nother thing. You study composition, it has to have an intro, a beginning, has to have good material in the middle, relating to the melody. It has to have a really great ending. And so if you listen to all of the great soloists, that's what you'll hear. Great beginnings, great middles, and great endings. And I know when I was learning and I was working, when I first started working with Max Roach, that was the first professional band I was ever in. For about a year or so, my main emphasis, every solo that I took was I wanted it to be a great intro. I wanted to start it off just right. And so I'd stand there and think, okay, what am I gonna do? And each time the chorus goes by, I'll say, oh, I could do this. And then somebody might do something that's playing. I'll say, oh, let me do this. You know, but I'm thinking the whole time. That's why I say I'm composing. I don't just wait until it's time to play and then just start moving my fingers up and down, you know. I'm thinking about this. I'm thinking about ideas someone else put out there. And I'll, you know, just to be funny sometimes or not, I will play what they played in their solo and try to turn it around and do different things, you know. So it's such a big difference between improvising and composing that I'm really insulted. It's as if I haven't studied all these years to learn how to compose a solo, to learn how to begin a solo nicely, how to play good stuff in between, how to reach climaxes when it's time, you know. I'll tell my students when they're learning a song to analyze it, and that's what we did, you know, Mozart and Beethoven, different composers, we had to analyze it and see. So I analyze every song. It could be Star Eyes. You analyze that. What's your favorite part of this song? What's your favorite harmony? What chords do you like in this song? What's the least favorite part? Where's the climax? You know, I'm asking myself all of these things when I'm composing a solo. So I hope this clears up this little argument between composition and improvisation, because if you think you're improvised, then maybe that's what you do. That's not what I do. I'm composing music.